What a story, Extreme. Okay, today, Death Road, to go to Death Road. Be like a monster. Let me translate. Hi, welcome to the stream. It's a really, really late Saturday night, Sunday morning stream. Or really early, depending on what time you're alive. And the other translation to that is we're going to get past the zombies and live and hopefully get to Canada. I kind of just got home. I was at a thing that I'll be talking about a little bit throughout this. And yeah, so I figured stream or no stream. That is the question. I opted for stream. I'm sure there's people that are upset that they have to wake up for this crap. And then there's other people that are just sleeping blissfully in a world of pure imagination and dreams. And they're so blissfully happy that they're asleep. And the rest of you just have to stay up and watch this. So you have my condolences, everyone. Yeah. Let's play some Death Road and we'll talk. I'll tell you a little bit about my day. At least the awake people get some pretty fucking sweet music. Alright, so we have a ton of characters from last time. You know, there's so many. There's so fucking many, so I may as well just use them. Oh, look at these bad games. Delete. Deleted. It's just the death noise. I would love for my fucking character to finally make it to Canada with his obliviousness. So that would be fantastic if that could happen. I'm also gonna go for someone from the chat. Let's go for Repulsive Imp, who made our most recent t-shirt for Red Fox. So Repulsive Imp, hopefully you don't get killed. Got a short trip. Let's do rare characters again. This is all good, too, because we get to level up skills like this, and rare characters are a lot of fun. Or you know what? No, let's do familiar characters. That way people from the chat could possibly show up. Or rare characters would be better, because then people could show up and we also get cool characters. Let's do it. So, this is your Death Road stream for the week. I haven't streamed this in about a week, but I've been enjoying this game a lot lately, as you can tell. Even having made it to Canada a few times. Unfortunately, has made it, but Vinny in-game character Vinny is an asshole that keeps dying and getting glitched. In fact, the developers tweeted me saying they were sorry that my character got glitched. I told them it was funny, and they said they like to make their game funny, but fair, at least. Let's do a quiet factory. So let's check out this factory. But yeah, one day Vinny will make it to Canada. There's a big update coming soon to this game. So that'll be fun. That'll have some new variety for these streams. But even so, I enjoy these streams quite a bit, and I feel like there's always the potential for something new and exciting to happen. I've seen some pretty amazing scenarios that I haven't seen yet in-game. Blowtorch? The fuck? Oh. Okay. That's a first. You can tell probably by my reaction that was a first. I have never seen a fucking blowtorch. So yeah, there's some news that I want to go over while I'm killing some Zambabos. First is Mario is officially on Steam. But the really weird Mario Brothers 3 show is on Steam. which just has me scratching my head. Like, what? Why that? Of all things. Not the Mario Brothers Super Show. The Mario Brothers 3 Show, where all the Koopalings have to sing a song. All the time. It's so strange. It's so very strange. Finally, Mario comes to Steam, and it's in the exact opposite form that we expected. That's the one where Luigi sounds like my impression. That's, you know... hey, Mario! That one. That's Tony Rosato, Luigi. There's some good episodes of that, actually. That was probably my favorite one as a kid, even though the Super Show is... For, you know, as I got older, I realized the Super Show was better because of the live-action segments. And Captain Lou's insistence on not memorizing his lines. You can tell Danny Wells carried the shit out of that show. I think that's it for the factory. Got a few things, I guess. Some food. Some tools. I got a fucking blowtorch, which is interesting. Sets up a camp. Who's gonna siphon the gas? I don't know what kind of stat is required for this. I'm gonna Vinny would be bad for this because... Well, let's try... Oh, here we go. Accidentally swallows a bit. Gets really, really sick. Oh, man. That morale decrease... That's a really substantial morale decrease. We did get a lot of gas, though. The group can't find the car keys. Oh, shit. Yeah, it's the thing. Vinny shoots the gator. Vinny whiffs the shot. The gator swallows the keys and waddles away. Vinny's shooting reveal- I don't understand! I'm a gun collector! You motherfucker! No wonder my character never fucking makes it. Also, is the game too low? Vinny's morale decreases. Look at the morale. Oh, this is terrible. The morale is so fucking low. Well, we at least found a goddamn car. Can the morale go up now? New car, tons of gas, shitty morale. People are gonna start abandoning and fighting. Stronghold or Ethel? Let's go to the stronghold. Plenty of gas for my blowtorch if needed. Yeah, it's been one day and already things are going, like, horrendously sour. Said it before, but this music makes me want to write surf music and not just bloody bagel music. I love this game soundtrack so much. Mainly for the guitar sound. What is that, a Mustang? I have a Jag and a Strat. I don't want to get a Mustang now. God damn it, game. Nah, it's probably... It could be either of those. Fender has that sound. Fender's very good for a sound like that. Fender is best guitar. Actually... Fender is one of my top three. Really, really into Gretsch at the moment, too. I kind of want a Gretsch. But anyway, that's just unnecessary. I've got a Rickenbacker. I don't need a Gretsch. Alright, so shop talk is over. I'm gonna stop that now. Because the more I think about guitars, the more I want other guitars. It's a slippery slope, you know? And it's an unnecessary slope. So... there was something horrendous that happened in Manhattan. I was not in Manhattan. Thank you everyone for the concern. There was a bomb. Like, how the fuck do you even talk about this on a video game stream? It's like, you don't, really. But I will just say this. Thank you for the concern. I'm fine. I was not in Manhattan tonight. I was not anywhere near Manhattan. I don't live in Manhattan. I live on Staten Island. It's all good. A lot of people showed a lot of concern, and I want you guys to know that that warms the cockles of my cold, engorged heart. But yeah, it was absolutely, it was sad, and it's fucked up, and I was just in Chelsea, not on, 6th Avenue, but I was like 8th Avenue-ish, just on Tuesday. So I was just in, I was in the Chelsea market, I was on the High Line, that was Tuesday, so then, like, 5 days later this happened, so yeah, it just kind of sucks that we have to live in a world where shit like that could happen, and it makes me appreciate a lot of things, you know, safety being the main one. It's just fucked. That's really all I can say about it. I have no other comment. I hope everyone makes a recovery, and I hope that the event is an isolated thing, obviously. That's the best I can say. As a New Yorker, I love this city. It does smell like rat piss. I do see rats carrying pizza upstairs every now and then in YouTube videos. Never saw that in real life. I do see rats from time to time, but not carrying pizza. Fort Fred. Named after the famous Vinesaw streamer, Joel. So yeah, I just want to thank you guys again for the concern. I'm doing okay. I hope everyone else is okay. If you live in the city, just be safe and avoid things that look like suspicious packages or rice cookers in the middle of the street, obviously. Just be safe. So, oh, that's a cleaver. I like the cleaver. Cleaver is a little bit better because it reminds me of the word Cleveland steamer. Now that's how you do a segue, kids. You go from serious stuff about being safe to talking about Cleveland steamers. That's why I have my own TV show here on the internet. No. Oh, they're getting aggressive. The zombies are aggressive. Tonight, I was invited, basically the past 2 days, I have not really been home. And, like I said, I kinda just got home, not too long ago. I was invited by Dave, who you've seen in chat a few times. I played a gig with him. I've talked about he does the Trollicitor videos that I've posted. Anyway, Dave invited me to this Talking Heads tribute band in Bethlehem, PA. They were doing a show at, how do you say it, Lehigh College? University? Lehi? Lehigh? Some good moves you got there, Repulsive Imp. Keep it up. Good fucking moves. Yeah, and see, now Vinny's doing it too. The fuck? Wait a minute, I think we already have pistols. Yeah, we have enough pistols in this group. This party does not need more pistol. So, the name of the band was Start Making Sense, and you probably know this if you watched me for a little bit. I fucking love the Talking Heads. I love the Talking Heads. And I especially love the Stop Making Sense movie. So when he told me, shit. When he told me that there was a thing happening where this band was going to be doing all of the Stop Making Sense movie, the concert, like shot for shot remake, I kind of thought that the hour and a half drive was worth it. So I did it, and it was worth it. They were amazing. They were absolutely amazing. They had, like, I've seen the Stop Making Sense movie, like, I don't know, a dozen times in my life, maybe more. And I know it fairly well, and they really nailed it. It was spot on. That was the closest I'll ever see to a Talking Heads gig. They were amazing. The dude sounded like David Byrne. The energy was great. He did the run. He had the big suit. He can't seem to face up to the fact. He sounded like that. He did crazy shit. It was a bizarre and amazing performance, and I really enjoyed it. And the audience was really into it. The audience was super into it. People were like dancing in this 900 person theater. People were like up, moving. It was hard not to move around because they did such a good job with the music. I'm tense and nervous, can't relax. Oh man, it was really, tribute bands have always been for me a hit or a miss, because I always wondered, like, what is it like to live in someone else's shoes when you're part of a tribute band, you know? Like, you have to kind of not do your own performance, but you have to live as someone else. But when I watched the sheer reverence that this dude had for the source material, the whole band. Fire Zombos. Are Molotovs new, by the way? I've never seen a Molotov until today. Did the new update come out? Holy shit! Oh, it's just an Otaku one. These break easy. Two hits for that one. Yeah, I think did the new update come out already? They've been in? Oh, that's interesting. I haven't seen them before. Anyway, I was always like, you know, you really have to live in someone else's shoes, right? Not only that, but when they did the Stop Making Sense, all of the little movements and mannerisms, all of the little jokes, all of the, anybody have any questions? Stuff like that. All at the proper time, all at the right moments, all of the moves were there. So I can imagine this thing taking years or a year or more of their lives to get right. And, basically any prejudice I had against tribute bands ended tonight because of how much fucking fun these people had on stage. Been a merchant was selling Molotov last time you played. Got it, thank you. My character just ate a fucking cat food can. Also, that dude looks like Martin Shkreli. Like a shifty-eyed Martin Shkreli. If that's how you say his name, I don't know. Who should stay up on watch? I guess, Vinny. Because... Repulsive Imp... was, having issues with sleep. I've seen The Machine do a Pink Floyd show, and they were pretty great. But that wasn't as good as this. Dentist's office. They find leftover medical supplies. Edible tubes of toothpaste. Technically edible tubes of toothpaste. Repulsive Imp goes to the waiting room and grabs a magazine. Celebs? Questionable Science? Glurge. Correct pronunciation is Martin Shithead. Thank you, Binary. You've educated me. I don't think I want to do celebs. Go Glurge. Still enjoys it. One story's about a cat that saves its owner from choking at a buffet. Inspirational. Well, our attitude and morale is increased. So thank you, Dave, if you're watching or not. Thank you for the invite to the Talking Heads tribute band. It was a lot of fun, and my feet were tired. I never got so tired just watching a show. Like, the energy, the sheer energy that was happening was tiring me out. There's probably a few other things I could say about it. But I can't think of them right now. They did a few other Talking Head songs after it was over. So that was cool. I was happy that they played Cities and Nothing But Flowers and stuff like that. Oh, there you are, Dave. In the chat. Thanks, buddy. It was a good time, man. Sturdy Machete for 12. No, I can't do it. Sturdy Machete is good, but I can't part with that much food. Treatment? No, we don't need treatment. Shotguns. No, can't really afford any of this crap right now. Yeah, the giant cupcake thing possibly gave me diabetes, by the way, so thanks for that. Maybe sleep? Let's see what's going on with everyone. Tired. Yeah, my character's tired. Maybe a good idea to sleep around the campfire. Let's rest. We lose food, but morale is increased, and we lose the tired status. I think it's worth it. Okay. I have something else to tell you guys. On my road trip, beautiful weather today. Fucking drive with the windows open, and this was like the perfect day for that. It was just so nice out. So, of course, how did I... Oh, they're fighting. God damn it! The car is driving down the highway, approaches a figure in the rain. Hold up. Hold that thought. It's a clown! Excuse me. Repulsive imp slows down to see who it is. It's a clown. It's so fitting. It holds out a little clown horn and honks. The sound is so distorted. We gotta let the clown in. I have a feeling this clown is gonna try to do horrible things. But I'm gonna let it in. Why did they do that? Why? The game is reprimanding me for letting the clown in the car. Clown joins the team. Onward to Canada. Repulsive imps morale. Okay, I thought the clown decreased morale. A horde is creeping nearby. We have to... it's a siege. It's a siege with a clown. I'm afraid of this clown fella. I don't know what to expect here. Clown is a funny clown. What a horrible description. At least the clown's happy. I think the comical choice here is to give the clown a frying pan. What do you say? Anyway, I listened to the audiobook of The Disaster Artist, which is the book that Greg Sestero wrote about the movie The Room that he was in, you know. Greg Sestero being, oh, hi, Mark. It's Mark. And I got through like 3 hours of it today. It is the most amazing thing I've ever listened to. Let me recommend the audiobook. Because you get to hear Greg Sestero's... You get to hear his impression of Tommy Wiseau. It's insane. He does such a good Tommy Wiseau. That's why I started the stream like that, because for the past 3 hours, I'm hearing all about Tommy Wiseau, and Greg Sestero's impression of him is so fucking spot-on hilarious. I was just laughing out loud. I must have, like, people that were driving nearby watching me laugh, like a mad clown escaped from a ward. Must have been like, what is that funny? It was incredible. There was one story about how, like, on the second day of filming... Nice. Okay, we made it. On the second day of filming, Tommy Wiseau is like... he's like giving the crew lip. Like, I got it. You can't really... do it justice, you know what I mean? You gotta just read or hear the thing. Preferably hear it, but there's this one moment where he's talking about, like, how he... someone farted on the set, and Tommy Wiseau was, like, just this dictator on the set. He was being, like, horrendous to his crew. And someone farted. He was like, that's disgusting! What you do? Why you do? That's gross! And as soon as I found that, like, could you imagine reprimanding someone for that? Yeah, when I heard the impression, like, why you do? It's disgusting. I fucking laughed out loud. I just, like, cackled. Like you've heard me on the stream. To myself, in a car. A beautiful, beautiful moment. So I just want to recommend the Disaster Artist book. Because it's had me in stitches, and it's really fascinating, too. You get to learn about this guy in a way that I never thought. And also, Greg is a very, very good writer and a very good narrator. I really like that guy a lot now. So, anyway, let's continue. Just wanted to throw some stories your way. Okay, let's do morale and random skill. My mechanical... medical and clown's mechanical is increased, and we got some morale. Why you do? That's disgusting. What the fuck? Why did my morale go up? Vinny thought the weather was nice. It was raining. Why am I enjoying the rain? That's so anachronistic to how I am, actually. Rain starts pouring, even though it was pouring a minute ago. Continuing our style. Let's keep driving. Impulsive imp strains her eyes, manages to narrowly avoid crashing into anything. We good. The group checks at an abandoned boxing gym, finds a woman there full in boxing gear. Non sequitur, random sayings about boxing. I'm gonna recruit. Contender has joined. Okay. Deadly or packed grocery store. I kind of want to do groceries. We really need food. Because we have nice gloves. We have little food. Even though the Yalmart would have had just as much food. Okay, so now, since we started shooting right away, these zombies are gonna be even more mega cheesed. That's the thing. As soon as that first shot is fired, the zombies get all stupid. And they're like, hey, that sounds like food. I swear, I think I'm a vampire. Bring all the attention this way. Yeah. Oh, mega cheesed. The food here is phenomenal, though. There's a lot of it. No, I'm not going in there yet. Just gonna stay mobile. Move around, make swift. I'm gonna make swift. I'm not much into celebrity gossip, but for some reason, I've heard many times about Taylor Swift having a new boyfriend and then breaking up with new boyfriend and then writing an entire album about said boyfriend. It seems like, does this just happen like once a year? At this point? Because I swear I've heard this story like 7 times. That's what it making Swift is. Oh. Smart, don't you think? Goodbye, repulsive imp. Goodbye, Vinny. I'm left with a clown and a boxer. Vinny is not allowed to make it. Sorry. Amazing. I actually legitimately thought that the fucking entrance was cleared of zombos. I really did. I thought that they were all outside. That couldn't have been further from the truth. Just gotta punch and honk our way to victory, I guess. I'm gonna set the AI to, I'm really upset about that, but I'm gonna set the AI to fight. Because that's what Contender does. This is not a good room for this shit to happen. I don't want to get crowded in here. We're leaving. Come on, Contender. Why you do? In fact, I don't even think that's what he said. I'm just now, at this point, just paraphrasing. To at least get the gun down there. ammo. Blowtorch. I kept trying to switch to the pistol while I was getting my ass handed to me as Vinny. When I was playing as Vinny. And then... just kept going back to the wrong weapon. Pistol was not happening. Sorry, Clown is the new party leader. It's me in spirit. This is me in my clown makeup, everyone. Speaking of which, someone asked earlier, how's Blood Bagel selling? It's doing really, really well. As well as our last album, if not better. So, I mean, for us, that's a huge success. And thank you, again, everyone. There is a little bundle that is kind of running out, if anyone is interested in that. It was still, it's still there on the site, but we're actually almost out of posters, believe it or not. Those were way more limited, and shirts are also pretty limited too, but yeah, so it's been a fucking hectic, crazy week. It's been immensely gratifying. We've had some amazing reviews. I made a little post about that. I've had someone, basically a number of people say that it was juvenile, and also that they were going to unsub from my YouTube channel. I mean, that's generally the response I wanted. So that was cool. That was cool. I got a bunch of unsubs as a result. And, I mean, really, that's really all I wanted. And at the end of the day, I got what I wanted. So, man, I mean, artistic fulfillment. I can tell you this, though. The reason we didn't do a booklet is because, once again, I kind of... did all the things. You know, I did the art, I did the back of the thing, I photoshopped the clown images, what else? Well, obviously the music, you know, kind of talked to people, did all of this was like basically stuff I've been working on for the past month. It's been pretty nuts. And I still haven't really had a moment to chill, so I'm gonna be chilling this coming week. That's for goddamn sure. Still hard at work on new music, some of which Dave is privy to at the moment. Don't tell anyone, Dave. Don't, like, do the songs with your voice. Don't be like, a confirmed new song, LP2 song. The ba-da-da-ba-ba-bop song. Vine Sauce, is that really your asshole on the album art? Yes, my asshole looks like a bagel. That is correct. So yeah. So, again, you guys have been great, thank you. Well, we lost some people. I just want to say, rest in peace, Vinny. You will never make it to Canada. There's gonna, at some point, I feel like it would be a good idea for someone to make a little death reel of every time Vinny has died in Death Row to Canada. Don't do it yet. Okay, but when I finally make it to Canada, that death reel has to happen. Even if you just get me the timestamps, I'll do it myself. I just need the timestamps of when it happens. Car repair and tune-up. Car pros. Clown tries to repair. Oh, clown's a she. She has no idea what she's doing. Wastes a day's time pretending to work on the car. Car may still break down at any moment. It looks all beat up, but still sturdy. Thanks, clown. My character would have just made a pass at clown, so this is for the best. Bookstore or umbrella. Let's go to the bookstore. Mm-hmm. I've never really specifically commanded Southbird to make any edits. Southbird usually just kind of does them. I did request an edit, which was the Castlevania Symphony of the Night death reel with the rune sword. That was just, I think that was kind of like one of those things that I just knew that I didn't want to do. To be perfectly honest, I was like trying to sugarcoat it. No, I didn't want to fucking do that edit. But that was the one that I requested. Handyman's Bible. Okay. And it turned out really, really good. So thank you for that, Southbird. I command thee to make a death reel of Zelda 2. Oh wait, you did already. I don't really like this clown's face, though. I can't tell if that's a smile or if it's just a shit-eating, like, weird grin thing. I don't like it. It's like, it kind of feels like... it kind of feels like... She wants to murder, like, real people and not Zombabos. Or maybe eat them? I don't know. It's like that's a wide enough mouth to eat brains. Like, the whole skull. Kind of like a snake, like, eats a fucking egg. I don't know, do they eat eggs? I just made that up. What do snakes eat whole? Like, meese? Meeses? Yes, they do. They eat eggs. Some eat eggs. I think I recall seeing a video of a snake sucking down an egg. I mean, it was, you know, back in college. You know, those days when you experimented. I was experimenting with snake egg videos just to see if it did anything for me. Didn't. I tried. However, there is this great one where the dude's like, it's nothing, it's only the smells. This clown is comically wielding this frying pan, and it's more effective than I thought it would be. Like, I thought it would just be like a gag, but nope, it's pretty good. Thank you, Glitched. I kind of figured out what the problem was for some of Super Mario Sunshine. I know that was a bit of a shit show, but I have some solutions. So that's some good news. A number of people have emailed me with solutions to the Mario Sunshine. No, I can't get this fucking voice out of my head. But a lot of people have emailed me saying that they know what they want me to do to possibly fix my Mario Sunshine streams, and some of them seem pretty goddamn confident. They know what the problems are. The reason I'm not doing that tonight is because I kind of just wanted to chill and not do anything like troubleshooty, because I did basically get home and, like, do a few load-off kind of things. Like, you know, relax. Like, just, like, oh, I'm not driving. This feels good. And then I started streaming pretty much immediately. Oh. The inscrutable clown has been scrooted. Oh, shit. So much good stuff in this house, though. I can't leave. Look at, there's a shotgun in here. Holy shit, what's that? Is that a railgun? I can't tell what that is. Oh, it's a wrench. There's a difference. There's a pretty big difference between railgun and wrench. So yeah, I hope that the sunshine problems will be resolved by the next time I stream it. I've also been slacking on Subnautica, but technically there's not a whole lot else to do except check out some unused areas. Are you serious, car? Holy shit! That's the longest it ever took to start a car. This car is fucked up. Well, at least the mechanicals have increased a little bit. So maybe we could fix the car, I don't know. I hope. Mini golf. Golf ball and putter while searching the area. The group decides to play a quick game. Well, I'm glad the clown and the contenders' morale is so high. Because, I mean, you know, they just lost the two original members of this party. Whoa, it's Lizard Godly! Thrown out by his former group. Hi, Lizard Godly. Are you in chat, Lizard Godly? If so, this is probably your lucky day. I hope. Let's hope you don't get eaten. Or clown doesn't fucking swallow your skull whole. The toll of 12 food. We have enough food. I'd rather not take the damage until we really need that to happen. Driving on death row, the group decides to make a stop for supplies. Herb? Commercial row. Let's check out the commercial row. Commercial district. Clown will be the keeper of the guns. Alright, let's see. Lizard Godly has resilience, some extra HP, which is great. Terrible wits. Contender's fitness is out of control, amazing. Muscle Bob Gym! Spaghetti only. Oh fuck, that's my kind of store. Alright, I have a confession to make. I don't really like spaghetti that much. I like Buttville Police. I like that too. And Apocalypse Coffee. Moe's Pub. Yo, this city sucks. All the buildings are blocked off. We got a hardware store. Spaghetti is okay. I will eat spaghetti if I have to. I can deal with it. I do like the other ones better, like the bow tie things. I like the things with the holes in the middle and other things. I don't like ravioli a whole lot because I kind of get sick of it. I feel like ravioli can be done wrong very, very easily, too. So, yeah, I like pasta. Not as big on spaghetti. Okay, Lizard Godly, you got something I want you to pick up here. Fucking chainsaw. I dropped the spaghetti, yeah, I dropped the spaghetti. I lost so many subs by talking about spaghetti not being my favorite. It's like you guys had these preconceived notions about me. However, pizza, I like as much as I say I do. Spaghetti, real fucking garbage, no. Spaghetti's alright. The shovel. The shovel is not doing the trick. It's slow. It's clunky. My character does not wield it well. Confirmed. Clowns do not do well wielding shovels. What toppings do I get on pizza? I think I answer this question like once a week. I really do. I get it though, because I stream so much that some people wouldn't have the answer. But I just kind of like usual toppings. Pepperoni, sausage, mushrooms, onions, black olives. I'd say those are my favorites. I could also do peppers. But my favorites are pepperoni and or sausage. I also like meatball. I think meatball's a good topping from a place that does meatball pretty good. Because some places don't have good meatball, as we all know. As you know! I had pineapple. No, I won't do pineapple on pizza. I know it's a meme at this point, but I just don't do it. But I'll tell you what. I had bacon on pizza tonight. I noticed there were like little... They snuck some bacon onto this pizza. Not good, man. I don't know if the bacon was off. I don't know if it was bullshit bacon. Like the equivalent of SpaghettiOs in bacon form. SpaghettiOs. Fucking garbage. Really, 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 really not good bacon. Everything else was good on the pizza. It was Pennsylvania pizza. And it wasn't bad for Pennsylvania pizza. But when the bacon moments happened, it tasted like squid anus. It wasn't Canadian bacon. It was clearly the other type of bacon. Come on, fucking start, car! Okay, go, go, go! Someone in chat just said, I love the portion of Vine Sauce where Vinny does pizza reviews. Sure. Well, that's something I can do from time to time. Clown attempt. Completely fails. Wastes a day. Cool. Wow, clown really fucking sucks at being a mechanic. You would think that she's only moonlighting as a clown, but during the day she actually fixes cars. All food and gas plus half of your ammo and medical supplies. These encounters are such poor shit. Seriously. Okay, no car to retreat to. Morale decrease. At least wounds are tended to somewhat. Okay, there's a car up ahead. This is the glitch encounter from last time. According to Google, squids have two anuses. You learn so many things of questionable veracity here at Vine Sauce. Every day I learn a new jape, but it could be true. I mean, I don't know. You know, Kim Jong-il was born under a double rainbow. I was born under a double anus. Oh, dear God, don't tell that information to those that make Splatoon fan art. That's the last thing we need. Why does it say super late? I don't know. I just thought I would inform people if they didn't know what time it was. I usually start around midnight. However, today, of course, I'm starting at... I think I started around 1:50. So, I mean, usually when I start late, I call that a late stream. Even though I'm streaming around this time anyway. I love how Contender just got that one last punch in. Fucking champ. Good thing we have a lot of food. And we're all healed up. We don't have any medical supplies anymore, but we're healed. car. A deer has stopped in the middle of the road. It stares at the car. Lizard Godly tries to shoot it. Completely whiffs it. Lizard Godly shooting is revealed to be absolutely terrible. Son of a fucking bitch. I gotta get something to drink real quick. Hang on, guys. I'll be right with you.
That's great. I wanna get some anime! Yeah! I'm gonna go to the anime trader!
Why is it tremendously easy for a fast, a Chinese place to fuck up hot and sour soup? It's like a 50% success ratio. Seriously. That's not why it smells like asshole. It's just the nature of it. It's like Thai beef. It needs to be, eliminated because it smells too much like asshole. Doesn't taste like asshole, but anyway. Hang on one second. Okay. Can your neighbors hear you shouting?
Thick walls.
True, it's true. Thick walls. Shotgun shells. I'm good for now. I've done tests. It's true. And I do not, in fact, I've had some pretty loud moments that were not, in fact, heard by anyone. I would hope. Anyway, medicine salesman. Man selling, firearms, revolver. No, it's not so great. This trader wasn't so good. One medical supply for each food. Let's do five. I'm just gonna be real cheap. Your group arrives in a huge city, conquered by the undead, and sees that their only chance is braving the sewer system. Okay. Alright, let's do it. You know what we need to save this run? Not that the run's going poorly. But you know what would really save the run? Carrot Nose. Every time I've made it to Canada, I've had Carrot Nose. Carrot Nose is my good luck carrot. Is Staten Island the smallest New York City? That's a very strange way to phrase that question. Haha, what a silly question. You know, don't plan, it might not come out the way you want. It is. I think Staten Island, population density-wise, is the smallest borough. I don't know about area. Visually, I can't really tell you because I think it is, but I don't know. Just in terms of population, it is the smallest borough of New York City. Uh-oh. This is a pretty thick swarm. Sewer clown. Do you think this clown is gonna smell really bad when it gets out of the sewer? As bad as that clown that night. You know, the staple clown. By the way, I met someone, one of our viewers, basically said that they knew the clown and had questioned me as to why I said, he was like, is the clown really that smelly? I said, yes, the clown was in fact that smelly. Yep. And he knew. It's just, you know, it's like sometimes you just, you know, you're busy working overtime, right? And you don't want to take the makeup off because it takes so long to put that shit on. So you're just clowning overtime around the clock. And, yeah, it was, it just, that clown doesn't wash sometimes. And that's okay. But, you know, you should really wash that shit if you're a clown. Everyone's morale is now, We went from, to, Some zombies roam around. Who should barricade the house? I don't know what stat this requires, but let's see. Attitude and fitness. Lizard Godly is pretty much garbage at just about everything, so I guess we'll try clown. Wow. Good job, clown. With that barricade. Really explore the space. Short reverb. Short. Bee flies into the car. This could be the biggest challenge yet. Contender swats the bee. It solves the bee problem but gets stung. Are you kidding me? Fucking contender, your fitness and strength is unparalleled. Excuse me. And a bee? Do we want another mouth to feed? Mega cheesed, but moderate. Look how just fucking cheese they are, holy shit. Lizard Godly's using that chainsaw like a little bit too much. This is the exact, precisely opposite way for the rescue. The chainsaw takes up gas from your car, I know. I kinda just let it happen. This Teresa? Sure, that's not a quote from Cave Story. Come with us if you want to live. Please. Arnold Schwarzenegger says the word please like John Cleese pronounces his last name. Please! it's kind of funny that Jake Lloyd wanted the Turbo Man action figure so bad in that movie, Jingle All the Way, and then a few short years later became his own action figure from Star Wars Episode I, The Phantom Menace, and then proceeded to have his action figure not be worth anything because no one wants Anakin Skywalker when he was a bad boy. You know what? I'm sure Anakin Skywalker action figure is worth money. It's another blowtorch. It's anything to get rid of our gas, I guess. I was so hoping this would be the science version of the factory with that machine that could turn one of us into like a fucking superhero or an invalid, one or the other. That would have been great. Does anyone know the date Vinesauce first streamed? The answer to that question is May 11th, 2010. It's the day before my birthday. And I don't know why that happened like that. I really could not tell you. Chrono Trigger was the first stream. Jen was the first viewer. Or one of the first five, and actually one of the few that stuck. There you go. As every, I just furnished you with every information that you needed. The factory rescue. Wasn't really a ton of supplies, but Teresa offers a tank of 80 gas. Oh, Jesus. Join the team. Maybe Teresa's good at something. I don't know. Let's see. Or at least good, better than Lizard Godly. Fucking Lizard Godly sucks. Cane, pistol, cane. Alright, we need to get rid of the chainsaw, dude. This is not conducive to a healthy environment for supplies. I'm not even sure how I feel about giving Teresa a gun. Thank you, Exile. Taking a break. There's an old man in a boat in the distance fishing. Start shooting. The world seems to shake. During the middle of this, he switches out for a shotgun. Holy shit. Bye, Teresa. Teresa finds a rowboat. It takes a while to get to the old man. The man doesn't talk, but his expression is hard to read, but he steps on, your boat. I don't get this reference, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'll see you later, Teresa. Even Teresa swam out in a boat to get Billy. And then just we brought him back. It's like, hey, how'd that conversation go? I kind of want to know. I want to, like, go behind the scenes and find out exactly how that went down. Teresa. So we've decided that we took a group vote. Clown just kind of laughed and giggled, but we know what that meant based on facial expression. Kinda. It was a very big smile. So anyway, we've decided that we want this old guy in the car instead of you. But I just rode out onto the lake to get him. Oh. Yeah, we just got you and everything. But do you think you can? Hey, what's that over there? Just drive away. Just drive away. It's just another day on the death road when someone farts in the car. Billy solves the mystery. Why you do? That's disgusting. Fart, disgusting. Don't even do that stuff. Billy explains a complicated sequence of deduction that arrives at one conclusion. It was Lizard Godly who was the farter. Wow. The car is completely run out of gas. Yeah, I wonder whose fault that is, Lizard. Bakery van. Bread is moldy and inedible, but there are some sugary cakes that are still good. Got a little bit of food. Morale increase. Can't drive the van, unfortunately. Without a car, a group is sitting duck for bandits. They demand 15 food. Why you do this? I have one medical supply. And we have a damaged clown. A damaged clown. Weighing my options, reading the chat. This is a tough one. This is a tough call, because it's going to be more than half of my food, or it's going to be a lot of damage. The group is hiking down a gravel road when they see a group of wrecked cars. Wow, look at this dude. Why is his stuff all amazing? I can't actually change out any of his equipment. Ridiculous fishing pole, Vlambeer shotgun. Hey, Vlambeer. Ridiculous pistol. Oh, ridiculous fishing. I know that game. Another fucking indie game reference, but Vlambeer is people that made Nuclear Throne, and I'm assuming also they've made Ridiculous Fishing. I've interviewed Rami. Well, KY did, but I've met Rami. He's really fucking cool. The dude is always swarmed, though. He has a lot of people come up to him and talk to him and ask him questions. Like, every time I see him at PAX or whatever convention, he is just amidst a swarm. And he looks super tired, and his voice is always shot. But he's always very animated, and he's always very loud. And he manages to somehow cut through the crowd. Like, he's someone that can, like, you can hear him from across a convention floor. Well, at least, like, four booths away. I'll give him four booths distance. But yeah, Rami's pretty fucking cool. Rami Ismail is the lead developer and the lead guy of Vlambeer, who made Nuclear Throne and Ridiculous Fishing and Luftrausers. Stop for supplies. Grocery rest. Let's do the Yalmart. There's food in there.
Get some ice cream for you.
So the old man took all my goddamn ammo. Clown is now useless. Shit. Whoa! What is going on? Oh!
What's going on? My screen! I can't see anything!
Clown, you've been supplanted.
What the fuck? That's a first.
Yeah, his weaponry is quite a bit better, I would say. Even though I can't see a goddamn thing when I'm using it.
Punk
is someone that I've kind of seen around. I don't really go to a whole lot of conventions, but the ones I do go to, he's usually there. He's kind of become a bit of a friend, and he's a cool dude, and he just sent me a copy of his $60 book that is probably one of the best video game related books I've seen in a long time, if not maybe my favorite that I own now. And, well, I mean, I'm gonna be as transparent as possible. Considering he hooked me up, I kinda wanna talk about his book for a second, if you're interested. It's, basically a guide to every NES game ever made, including bootlegs, flash carts, rare challenge carts, basically anything about the NES ever is in this book. It took him years to write. And it is a massive, insane undertaking of a book. And I have been reading bits and pieces of it, and it's excellent. So, I have to say, I'm really proud of him. You know, my thing is music. I like to make music. That's my... You know, if I'm gonna put a few years or a year of work into something, it's gonna be an album. But Pat somehow had enough fucking patience to get a book made, and I don't know how he did it. I don't know how he had the patience for it, because again, this thing is hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of pages, and it's pretty fucking insane. So, how thick is the book? It's very thick. It's Mondo thick. I think it's... I mean, you could kill someone with this book. That's my review of it. It's massive. It's a coffee table book that would break a glass coffee table. It's about 450 pages, and I just accidentally flipped open a page and saw a Hitler exploding. So that's cool. There's an article about Nazis in this book, apparently. Anyway, yeah, so I just wanted to kind of, as a favor to him, he's done a lot of cool stuff for me. He's given me copies of his shit. His actual feces, by the way. And, I did a little Star Trek thing with him. He's always been super supportive, and, I like his podcast a lot. I think he's a really genuine, smart YouTuber. And, yeah, I like him. It's just called The Ultimate NES. If you go to ultimatenes.com, you'll see it. It is expensive, and I'm not trying to, like, push it on anyone. However, yeah, I tweeted pictures of it. Ultimate Nintendo Guide to the NES Library, 1985 to 1995. ultimatenes.com. Thank you for the book, Pat. And he gave me, he's a big Vine Sauce fan, and he gave me some codes to give to you guys for the digital version. So, I'm gonna do that. If you guys want it, if you want a digital copy of it, it has all the informations. I'll do a raffle in a little bit at the end of the stream. And if you want to win a copy or two, I'll have a few of those. So yeah. Throw trash at the end of the alley. I've done the parkour one last time. I'm going to throw trash this time.
So I throw garbage.
Oh, that didn't work out. That was fucking shit. Whoa, it's Jack. It's nice to see a familiar face. He's fighting a single zombie. Never mind. Sorry, Jen. I would have replaced Lizard, but Lizard is not an option for replacement, sadly. Jen carried the group last time. Schmellows or tell stories. Let's do Schmellows. You know I can't get rid of Billy. I can't get rid of Clown. And the contender is just a beast. The group is ambushed by a yelling man, ranting and raving. He doesn't look particularly dangerous, but those rants are starting to sizzle. The highlight of the words, first of all, the use of the word sizzle, I just have to fucking applaud, but the fact that it's highlighted, it's fucking Liquid Ocelot. He's gonna shoot with his fingers and scare us off. I love it.
Brother.
The group fights the cantankerous man. It's over very quickly. He ended up doing some damage before he ran off. I saw most of the chat saying to fight that dude. What a mistake that was. Medical clinic it is. Cantankerous old man with sizzling rants. I wonder if George Carlin was the inspiration for that character. I like cantankerous old men. I like when they rant and rave. Except when it's about traffic. That gets annoying, because there's only so much you can say about traffic, really. Unless you happen to be caught in traffic on Coney Island, when a cantankerous old cunt by the name of Mike Love sends his lapdog, John Stamos, to watch you pee into a bottle while getting filmed for a porno directed by Mike Love at the expense of his brothers that are no longer, his cousins that are no longer in the Beach Boys. Like, they paid for it. He's just getting all, he's reaping all the benefit of that. You know what's great about telling that story and making it weirder and weirder each time? Is that the people who didn't hear it any of the other times, like the new people to the stream, or the people that just weren't around for the previous ones, have no idea what I'm talking about. And it is a glorious thing to look in the chat and just see question marks. Just confusion. That's my favorite story. Yes, it is my favorite story. And I'm gonna tell this goddamn story until the day I die, and I swear to God, it won't be the same each time. It's gonna be like Monkey News and Carl telling a story. Well, you know what? No. It's gonna be like Rockbusters when Carl tries to tell the clue, the cryptic clue, and he just changes it every time. A different clue. Carl, you're an idiot. Carl, you're an idiot. Hang on a second. Just one second, what is this? Oh. Alright. Medical supply. I should write a book about- I should write a 450-page hardcover book about everything there is to know about the night that Mike Love and John Stamos plotted together to watch me piss blood into a bottle while I was stuck in traffic. tell my YouTuber friend, Pat Contry, to promote it and give codes to him. The Ultimate John Stamos Guide to Peeing in a Bottle, forward by Mike Love. Oh yeah, yeah, no, they were disguised as police officers, that's the other thing too. They fooled me into thinking they were cops. They weren't. Turns out they were lizard people in disguise.
Water's making frogs gay!
Excuse me, I had a little Alex Jones in my throat there for a second. I don't know how that happened. Oh god. Oh, it got shit got real out here. And the clown does not have a lot of health. Oh fuck. Oh no.
Old man, no, no, no!
Billy's dead! What the fuck, Billy? Why do you suck so much? Switch to your goddamn weapon, you fucking cock! I have all these great weapons with Billy. Does he use them? No, he just goes and gets himself fucking decimated by a zombie horde. There were not that many zombies out there last time. I don't know how they found me. Shit. Too late to get Jen. I haven't seen a single medical supplies yet in this medical clinic. I need medical supplies. I especially need them right now, because now I only have fucking two party members left. Here we go. Here's the medical supplies. Thank you, Joseph Smith. I wrote an email to Nardwar. I guess the same compulsion that a lot of you had to email me, I kind of felt it, because I was watching some Nardwar interviews, and I watched this TED Talk. If you don't know who Nardwar is, just type it in YouTube, N-A-R-D-W-U-A-R, and then if you want a good start, type Nardwar Snoop Dogg. Nardwar Snoop Dogg. Watch any of his Nard interviews. Nardwar is my favorite interviewer on the planet. He is amazing. He's the human serviette. So, I see there's some Nardwar fans in the chat, so I just want to say keep on rocking in the free world, and, doot doot loot doot. Yeah, 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 stay in there, yeah, yeah, fight, yeah, yeah, get fucked up, yeah, whoa, whoa! God, I was gonna try to hit. Oh no! Oh! Oh no! Oh, I couldn't even get all that ammo and shit. I couldn't get the weapons, I couldn't get anything. Clown. Clown took 6 medical supplies to heal 2 HP. I need help here. What's going on here? What is this? Clown passes through a graveyard. Nearly every grave has been dug up, most from the inside out. There are three graves in a row, undisturbed, with the names Grid, Nicholas, Louis. Luigi? I don't know what this fucking thing is. I don't know what this is. Hagrid? Nicholas or Luigi?
Hagrid, take it out. Fucking massive, mate.
Dig up Lou. There's no fate but what you make. It's filled with guns. A ton of guns. Three pistols, two shotguns, and two hunting rifles. Hoping it would be Luigi. So, but I can't sell some of the shit that I had. Because then I could get that assault rifle in exchange for all these weapons that I don't need. These are slow. Went from worse to bad. Rifle ammo. Rifles now. I may as well fucking use them, right? Also, I am aware of how amazing my vehicle is. Overwhelming siege for 1.5 hours. Oh, fuck. Anyway, the thing with Nardwar, I was saying. He emailed me back in like 5 minutes. And he just, it was a brisk email, but he said, thank you. He said, this is amazing in relation to Blood Bagel. And he told me to keep on rocking in the free world. And he said that he was very happy for my success. And I was so happy to get that email back. So thank you, Nardwar. Your Nard Schwet, may it forever live on. Oh, there's police officers in here. What's going on? I have some help. Ready to rock. I'm just gonna stay with them. They look like they know what they're doing. They're so fucked. Oh, my cousin Spagublio is a police officer. I'd love to escape. I'd love to escape! Shit. Clown was not very quick with that rifle, sadly. Yeah, I can't do another one. It's a little late for another one. So, that's the end of that. Well, that sucks. I'm trying to think of if there's anything else I want to do. I mean, maybe we'll just keep it a short stream, because I was like massively tired when I came home, and I kind of had a little bit of coffee and that woke me up, but I feel like I could just like pass out right now. So I might do that. Let's raffle off a few keys. How's that sound? And then I'll check the art. So tomorrow, hang on a second. Tomorrow there's going to be a bunch of stuff. I have a shovelware showcase tomorrow, guys. And that'll be fun. I have a lot of new shovelware garbage. I also have your assorted random odd job crap. And it'll be fun. So that's tomorrow. And I may have a full cluster truck stream very soon. Now, before I do anything, I'll throw on some music while I do this raffle. And also, hang on. I hope this is on here. Tommy Wiseau fart story. No. Damn it. Disaster. Artist fart story. No, wow, I'm surprised there isn't more of this fucking audiobook on YouTube. That's actually kind of surprising. Maybe it was taken down. I think I want you guys to hear really quick, though. Greg Sestero's...
Next to me was a guy mistakenly assumed was another extra. In fact, the carrot juice back...
I kind of want you guys to hear his Tommy Wiseau impression before we do this.
...back into his fridge. On his refrigerator door at all, it was in fact a very sad line. And maybe Tommy should shoot for a response that was more, shall we say, joined us on the side of the rooftop set. He looked for a long time at Tommy's water bottle before speaking. What's this? Water bottle, Tommy said. Sandy took in a lungful of deep, calming breath. Yes, he said. I know. What are we doing with it? I need to throw something, dammit, during scene. Sandy turned away, removed his glasses, sat down, and rubbed his eyes. Tommy headed back to the outhouse, his water bottle in hand, and his script hidden in his breast pocket. I sat down. Sandy stood by the monitor. Action! The door flew open, and there was Tommy holding his water bottle and stepping out of the outhouse and hitting his head on the door jamb so hard that it took 20 minutes to ice the bump and conceal it with makeup. I heard one of the cameramen say desperately, "How are we ever going to get this? It's impossible. We'll be here forever." Then, just for comic relief, Don and Brianna arrived on set to pick up their checks. Tommy, sitting in the makeup chair while Amy iced his forehead down, ignored them at first. Brianna talked to Juliet as Don ginned up the courage to approach Tommy.
Okay, I don't think there's going to be any more Tommy impressions here. I'd have to skip around. And the fart story is somewhere in this section. But the idea being, this is the world's most incompetent filmmaker. And I was talking about this earlier. If you missed it, it's the audiobook for The Disaster Artist, which is based on The Room. Greg Sestero, who played Mark, it's his basically his memoirs of The Room and his life with Tommy Wiseau. Well, not life, but his life experience with Tommy Wiseau. which is the most amazing shit I've heard in years. So, anyway. Let's see. Okay, we're going to do this giveaway if you want this book. And let me see how this happens, because they change this raffle system constantly. Users, how does this work? Okay. Keyword entry. Hang on, guys. We're going to try keyword entry. Subscribers. Okay. Okay. Now, here's how we're going to do this. If you want this book, this is the, I'll show you my picture of it. It is the Ultimate NES Compendium. And it's kind of incredible. And this is for the digital version. So I don't really fuck with digital books. I'm not going to lie. I don't do that very often, if ever. But I'm sure there's some people that could make use of it and would enjoy it in that format. And if you do, then good on you. This is what it looks like. And it basically is the most complete compendium of any kind of NES related stuff I've ever seen. I mean, I wouldn't imagine it gets any more detailed than this. And there's also reviews for the games and little like personal thoughts and everything. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Writing is good too. I've enjoyed it. But yeah, so that's what the book looks like. If you want it, I've got a few keys for you. So what you do is only once, do not type it more than once. If you type it more than once, you can actually be made ineligible. So there's going to be a keyword that you type, and this keyword I'll tell you in a second. But remember, you cannot type it more than once. I'm serious. If you do, you actually get removed from the raffle. So it will not increase your chances. So you ready? Here we go. Wait, how the fuck do we do this again? Okay, I got it. Okay, here we go. Reset. And wait a minute. No. There was no giveaway. Beastie Gerbil, you won shit. I'm sorry. You didn't win anything. I apologize. No one typed the keyword. Wrong. Sorry, Beastie. There is no keyword. That was an accident. I pressed the wrong button. Wrong. No, the keyword is exclamation mark book. Now everyone's spamming wrong. Oh, god damn it. I really need to get my shitty pickles together. Okay. Exclamation mark book. Poor Beastie. It said he won, but in reality, he didn't. There was no keyword. I don't even know how the fuck that happened. Oh, dear God. I apologize, dude. Well, you win my respect because you're always here at the stream. So thank you for that. How's that? Is that the same as winning an audiobook? Or rather, an ebook or whatever? Okay, so I think the time is just about up now. So we're going to do the drawing now. So, you ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Carmenia! You're another chap that's been here for a while. Carmenia, congratulations. I'm going to send you a message with every information you need. And you have won a copy of this, the digital version. So I hope you enjoy it. Again, thank you, Pat, for always being super fucking supportive of what I do. And also, thank you for the codes. Okay, how do you redeem this thing? Okay, I think I have it. So, Carmenia, check your... There's going to be a few more codes, don't worry, guys. Check your check your messages on Twitch. All right, you're gonna see a message. Let me know if you got it. So send me a message back as soon as you can. And I'll let you know if, let me know if it worked, and I'll let you know nothing, actually. All right, so next, there's gonna be a different keyword. Okay, we're gonna try a different keyword just to make sure everyone has a chance, the people that type the keyword twice, whatever. The next keyword is going to be, and only type it once. If you type it more than once, you lose eligibility. The next keyword is going to be... exclamation mark splurgle. Let's see if you can spell that shit. Have fun. Oh, nice. A lot of you guys got it. It's S-P-L-U-R-G-L-E. Exclamation mark S-P-L-U-R-G-L-E. I could have made it so that the contest required you to fucking guess how to spell this stupid word correctly, but I didn't want to be that mean. Exclamation mark, fuck that word. I don't know. So yeah, Carmenia, once again, once you redeem and everything's working, just send me a quick message back. Okay, we're gonna do this now. So, 10 seconds. Remember, there's a delay between you and I. So, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the winner is... This is Norm. Oh yeah, there's metal stuff too that I wanted to show you guys. If you give me a second, I can do that since we have a little bit of time. This is Norm. Congratulations. You just won a copy of the Ultimate NES, yada yada yada. And check your thing. There's a digital download with instructions. It would be great if you were Norm McDonald, but something tells me you're going to be a semi-inferior Norm. Alright, check your fucking messages. Let me know when it works. Message me back, because if it doesn't work, then I can probably get you set up with another one. So, there you go. And I'm gonna give out two tomorrow as well. I'm going to do one more with one new keyword. It's gonna be an easier keyword this time, guys. Alright, so let's do one more. The keyword this time will be exclamation mark space, because the name of this song is Waiting Around for Grace from an album called Man It Feels Like Space Again. I don't really know why I even made it space, but yeah, sure, it's an easier word. Everyone knows how to spell that, right? S-P-A-C-E exclamation mark space to enter, and you can win a digital copy of the Ultimate NES book. Eventually, we'll do more Steam key giveaways. People used to hook me up with lots of Steam keys for giveaways, but it just became like, I remember so many trash games. Like, Vinny, I have this game I don't want. Maybe someone else will. It just takes so much time for a giveaway. For garbage games. You know when you look at a word long enough? And, it doesn't look like the real word anymore. Like, I'm looking at the word space so much, I don't even know if it's a word anymore. It just looks like a random collection of letters. It's so fucking weird. It's losing all of its meaning, one post at a time. Okay, you guys ready? I see a lot of people have entered. Let's roll it. 3, 2, 1. Hi, Hootie. And the winner is Super BMISU. Super BMISU. Congratulations. You know the rules. Check your Twitch messages and you'll have a download code with instructions. I'll have a few more chances to win. By the way, this is a $30 value. You know, this book took, like, I think 2 or 3 years to write. Boyhood took 12 years to make. So it's like 1/4 of the time it took Boyhood to get made. Pretty impressive. But yeah, it's a pretty substantial prize, I would say, for the amount of work that was put into it. And, you know, it's entertaining. It's a fun read. So you'll have 2 more chances to win tomorrow during the stream. And I thank you guys for your patience and your interest in this. Thanks to Pat for putting out always really good stuff and for being a really down-to-earth, chill YouTuber that does not play up things and does not... I mean, I go out of my way to say stupid shit from time to time, and it's... You know, he doesn't do any of that. He's just a chill dude. And he has some really good video game talk. And his podcast pretty much is just him being as real as anyone. So I really like what he does a lot. And, yeah. So. I recommend him. I guess that's about it for the giveaway. Again, if I emailed you, or if I messaged you, rather, just let me know that you got it to work. Carmenia did. Apparently, it worked well, so. Okay, I want to show you something else, if you don't mind. For anyone who's here for video games, they're gone. They're done. Video games are over. Sorry to say. I talked about the Talking Heads tribute thing that I watched earlier. And I actually have some pictures and video of that, but maybe another time. I do want to show you one of the coolest things I've received in the mail from a Vine Sauce fan. And I've said this before, I know it's like sappy to talk about this kind of shit frequently, but I really do count my blessings, because when I get stuff in the mail that people have, like, handmade, it makes me really appreciate what I do so much more, and I feel really grateful. You know, because this is not, like, this particular thing is not something that someone just bought at a store, which I'm always okay with too, but let me show you. Before I show you, actually, I have to find out who the fuck sent this to me. who sent this to me? Dear God, I actually don't know. I'm checking my email, but my email is so clusterfucked that it's hard for me to find anything. Oh, okay, here we go. It's from Michael. Michael P. So I don't know who you are in chat, Michael P, but thank you for this. So Michael P made this shit. And check it out. So it's a Star Trek bottle opener and a Vine Shroom. And also the Vine Shroom, that's a pretty substantially sized thing. That's not small. If I can give you a frame of reference for how big that is, It's about the size of a waffle. And that's the first thing that came to mind. Okay, waffles can be different sizes. It's a little bit bigger than a Blu-ray or a DVD. Like, maybe, you know, a few inches bigger around the circumference, I guess. I don't know. It's really, really heavy, too, and it looks great. So, I mean, people are very creative in this community, and I've had people send me some amazing stuff. Like, Repulsive Imp sent me some stuff that was like felt, needle felt. I've received plushies, shirts, a hat, a Red Vox hat. That was awesome. And anyone who I haven't thanked personally, I want you to know, like, I really, really appreciate it. I just get a little bit clusterfucked, overwhelmed, forgetful. And it doesn't mean I don't love that stuff. I actually do show it off to my friends when they come over, and then they just, like, the hatred for me grows a little bit further, like, a little bit more each time. Like, oh, check out this cool stuff. And it's like, oh, yeah. Yeah, I wish I had people sending me stuff. So it's great that I get to lose my friends one by one with all the cool stuff that you guys send me. Worth it. Fucking worth it. In all seriousness, this community has been very creative, and we have a lot of great artists. We have a lot of great people that make things by hand, that sell things. I've been asked to promote stuff, which sometimes most of the time I don't do because it just gets crazy. But like I said, when you kind of spend this much time doing stuff, like, and making plushies and shit, it's just every now and then I have to show you. Keep in mind, too, that a lot of people have made great things for the charity stream, and have, you know, that body pillow comes to mind. There was, you know, plushies that were made by Rachel, and it's been a really, really, really good few years getting to see the community really come together and also do nice things for me and the other streamers. So anyway, yeah, sappiness, I get it, it's sappy, but really, it needs to be said every now and then how grateful I am and how grateful I think we all are. So, cheers. Let's check out the art, and then I'll get going. And again, tomorrow night, Shovelware Showcase, and a bunch of other new shit. There we go. Okay, what do we have here? There's, there's some really interesting art. Hopefully Mario Sunshine will work really well without, like, too much of a hitch next time. Because, that's gonna be a fuckload of fun. This one is from Shoveltooth, and it is a BRB. A very cool landscape. This one's from Chib Shroom. And it is a vine shroom. This one's from Lemon Lime. And it is a vine shroom eating a blood bagel with a deranged look in its eye. Oh, fuck. From Neko. Neckobble? Is that the name? Neckobble Yells? It's some Mario Sunshine art, and it is me. From Desert TV. Desert TV, what the fuck? I see how I got confused, because there's a BBTV. Okay, so this is an emote that he made. It's a pepperoni secret. And it is actually an emote that I can enable on better Twitch TV. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. So that way we can start pepperoni secreting it up in the chat. Listening once again, the album is Pond, and the name of this song is Zond. The one after this is called Heroic Shart, which is a great name for a song. I highly recommend that song name. You can only have 5 shared emotes at this time. Okay. Really? Okay, now it'll be available. It's PEP, capital S, secret. So PEP, secret, with a capital S and nothing else capital. Alright, so from some repulsive imp, here's what I was saying about creativity. Did I show this the other day? I think I did. But it's there again, and it's pretty fucking awesome. So, yeah. It's a chest burster. It's amazing. From Vine Odyssey. Fuck bees. From Epic Sauces 39. Escape. Escape. Op. Delete. From Dull Vivid. I can show you a pepperoni secret. If you just give me a chance. That face. That's a good one. It's a really fucking good one. This one is from Gamma Pulse. Go. It's just me saying hey. This one's from Adelendian. Holy shit, what's going on here? Oh! That's what I would imagine some picture people. Some people picture. Wow. Some people picture the end of Between the Cheeks. Our singer was a bee. Anyway, this art is pretty fucking great. And Adelendian, I've said this before, but you have the magic touch when it comes to memes. You've done some really good art in the past. It's been really great. Let's see. Oh god, this one's great. From Otaku AP. Here's me in full clown regalia. Still have the costume, you know. And there's the BRB blood bagel. I fucking love that. Dear god, that is amazing. Yeah, so how about that clowns? How about that clowns? Okay, we got more art from today's stream. There's been a ton of art that I missed or that you guys submitted within the past 48 hours. From Kazili SB. Here's a shroom render. It says it's animated, even though I don't see any animation. I don't know if it's a GIF. Oh, it is a GIF, yeah. It's just a massive fucking GIF that's taking forever to load. Well, I will transfer that over. From Sofino X. Super Mario Sunshine. Just a friendly reminder that this level exists. Which one is that? You know what? Oh, the pachinko level. Oh, yeah. I didn't remember that. This one is from Kayla Tebedo. It is I. It's cool. This one's from Hap Ballantines. The Legend of Pizza. A Ralph Between Bovins. I like the Pizza Triforce. That's fucking on point. From Lape. It's an animated shroom. Also, here's that animated BRB. That's really, really cool. For some reason, I dragged it into XSplit and it just disappeared. Oh, wait, hang on. Here it is. It is 26.9 megabytes. That's how big that GIF is, which it's got a pretty massive resolution. So I kind of understand it, but yeah, that's really good. This one is from Jomsh, and it is, yeah. I just can't live in that game. This one's from Tremendous by Design, and it is Gorilla's version of Red Vox. That's so cool. Wow. Yeah, I really like that. I like the when people do the Gorilla's stuff. Oh my god. So this one's from Bun Time, and it is a Red Vox blanket. Holy shit. It says, another dumb blanket thing I made, probably gonna send this to you eventually if I can get it to fit in a small enough box so you and Mike can snuggle. Well, that last part doesn't sound so great, but everything before that, I was totally down. How the fuck long did this take? Because that is incredible. Also, people are like, I want to buy two. I want to buy three. That would probably be like... You could probably produce like 17 of these in your lifetime. See, there's the 17 again. But yeah, you might be able to produce like 17 of these if you just, you know, spend the rest of your life doing this. So, I'd say go for it. It'd be worth it. Just sell them for $5. Seriously though, I know people would buy this, and I think this is beautiful. So thank you for this, and thank you for the effort, and for the support. God damn. What was I saying before about people being creative and amazing? From Hap Ballantines, here's a Ralph. Again, from Link Between Bovins or whatever. That's cool. This is one of my favorite songs from this album. I think, actually, this is my favorite song from this album. This is Sitting Up on Our Crane. I like this one a lot. From Pun Star Tracer, Honk Honk Muffucker. Goddamn. From Bloody Shy Guy. Me trying to catch after Shadow Me in Mario Sunshine. This one's from Mullet Muffins, and it is Clown and Contender from Death Road just now. This one's from Nutmeg Raccoon. It's the moderation team, but in camera form. Go ahead and save that for them. That's awesome. From Your Shad Sauce. Oh look, mouth sounds. From Mario Sunshine. Awesome. From Anonymous 64-bit. Well, I mean, it's a self-loathing traditional drawing. I've taken to the habit of calling stuff on paper with pen and paper or pencil and paper or any assortment of things with paper traditional, because for a while I was just saying on paper. But that doesn't necessarily mean that it's not digital or whatever, so I figured traditional just is an all-encompassing term for I didn't do this on my computer. From what I understand, that's the best way to do it. From Elena D. Here's, speaking of the word traditional, this is, it says watercolor, it's tagged as watercolor, and it is more shrooms. This one's from Monterang, and it's Splatoon. Squid yums! From Daxter Doodle. We'll be right back. And from Vine Odyssey. There you go. So yeah, thank you guys so much. The art was excellent tonight. You guys have done a great job, as always. And I am very lucky. So I'll leave you with this. I like this one. I like Vine Dinosaur wanting to be right back. But that'll happen another time. For tonight, I leave you with this, and the end of the song. And again, you know the rules. You know what I'm going to say next. Go to twitch.tv/team/vinesauce for the rest of the Vinesauce streamers. And for check out their work, check out their channel, watch them, buy them a pizza, whatever you want. It looks like the site is kind of down and, you know, at the moment. So I'll just say use the twitch.tv/team page for the time being. I think that'll probably fill your gizzard. Yeah. So I'll see you guys tomorrow with shovelware and a bunch of other shit. Thank you so much for joining me on this late adventure. Sad that we didn't make it, but I figured, hey, why not? Why not do a 2-hour quick stream? I hope you enjoyed it, and have a great one. Night.